Hey everybody, it's Cameron Thumb. I'm going to show you how to modify a rectangle mesh and move each edge individually in Fusion and stuff. So today we're going to walk through how you can make a rectangle mask in Fusion do something like this, where you can modify each edge individually and move it around freely. We are going to build this tool from scratch, but if you want the expressions, they are in the description, so you can find them there. Also, I do sometimes do just follow the lower third, you know the drill. There's lower thirds, Twitch, I stream on YouTube as well. Fun, yay. Now going back here into Fusion, I'm just going to go ahead and delete this rectangle mask for now, and we're going to create a new one from scratch, and I'm just going to plug this into the MIDI out because we don't actually need it connected to anything to create this tool. Now in order to make this tool work, we do have to create our own custom parameters, and we can do that by right-clicking on the node and going to Edit Controls. And if you would like a longer deep dive on the Edit Controls window, just let me know. But the first thing we're going to do is just type the name of the parameter that we're going to add. So the first one we're going to add is going to be called position. I'm actually going to change this type to a point because it's basically going to be the same as center. A point is just a way of telling Fusion, hey, this has two values. So we're going to make sure we turn on offset control and crosshair control. Offset control means that we'll be able to see it here, and crosshair control is the display overlay on the actual viewer. And then we want to just make sure we tell it which page of these tabs we want to put it on, which is going to be controls. So I'm going to go ahead and hit OK, and there's our new parameter. And then we need to make four more, one for each edge. So if we go back into Edit Controls, I'm going to go ahead and type in top. We can leave the type number because it's just a single parameter. And we're just going to make it a screw control, make sure it's on the controls page. And we're going to set this to 0.25, set the default to 0.25. Because basically what we're doing with these parameters for the top, bottom, left, and right is we're setting these to a value that's this much offset from the position center point. You'll see exactly how that's working in a minute. But we're going to go ahead and hit OK here. And then we're just going to make the other three. And for bottom, it's going to be the same thing. We're going to do screw control, controls, except now for the default is going to be minus 0.25. And then we're going to do the same thing with left and right. Editing Tim here, I realized after I recorded this that left and right actually don't copy and paste like normal because they technically have other properties. So you'll see me call these next two controls left and right, but name yours something else like left edge or whatever works to help you remember. And then when the expressions are explained later, replace left and right with whatever you called your controls. And that's it. Editing Tim sends it back to Camera Tim. So left, now left in the x-axis, on the left side that's 0, and right side is 1, so if we're going to the left that means we're subtracting, so we need left to be minus 0.25. We're going to make a screw control, put it on the controls page, hit OK, and then last but certainly not least, because it's basically the same as the other three, we're going to put right, screw control, controls, and because it's on the right side we're doing 0.25. So now we have our default values and our new point control here, and now we need to start creating expressions. Now we'll start with the easy ones first. So basically how this can work is with the width and height, all we need is just to calculate the difference between either the left and right or the top and bottom. So with width, all we have to do is just subtract the higher value from the lower value. In this case, this would be right from left, so we'll just do right minus left. Now when we change left and right, it is moving the width. Now of course it's not complete yet because we don't have the rest of the expressions in, but this is the baseline for what we're going to do. And also this is going to be a nice little nifty tip if you want to add this. You can also put in ABS or absolute and then just put a parentheses around right and left. And that essentially just means it's always going to be a positive value. So if I increase this and it goes into a negative value, that means it's always going to stay positive. That's just a little nifty trick you can do. And for height, it's the same thing. We're going to do ABS, parentheses, top minus bottom. And now top and bottom move it as well. So now the big expression is going to happen on the center parameter, because in order for us to make it seem like we're moving one edge individually, the center has to be compensated. So we're going to go ahead and right click on our center and hit expression. Now it's going to put this point on by default. Again, a point function just means there's two values. So the first one is this box. So if I change this point to 0.25, it changes this box. If I change this to 0.75, it changes the y box to 0.75. So this is just denoting that this is the first value, this is the second value, and a comma is what separates both of them. So now we have to tell it exactly what we want to calculate here. Let's start with the x value here. So the first thing we need to do is we need to just grab the position x. So let's just go ahead and we can actually just pick whip this down to position. It's going to grab whole position. We just want the x value. So the way that we can tell it we're looking for the x value property specifically is just by putting period x. And now position x actually controls the center x. So that's a good start. And now in order for the center to compensate properly, we need to do a little bit more math here. We basically need to do the opposite of this. We need to add right and left together. We need to take this position and then add it to the result of the sum of left and right divided by 2. And the way that we can write that out is we can just make sure we put a plus in here. And then in parentheses, we're going to put in left plus right divided by 2. Now, in order to make the order of operations correct, we want to divide the result of left and right by 2, not divide right by 2. So we can just put a parentheses around left and right, so it looks like this. And now, if we move our left and right, you can see that it moves our edges accordingly. And then, of course, we just do the same thing for the y value, except we just switch up to parameters. So we just do position.y plus, and then double parentheses, top plus bottom, one close parentheses, divided by 2, and then one more close parentheses to get the full scope. And now if we move top and bottom, we have our full individual edge adjustments. And if we move our position, it still centers it perfectly. And so basically what top, bottom, left, and right are doing is it's showing the amount that it's either adding or subtracting from whatever this position is set to. And that's how you create the tool. Now, if we wanted to save this as default, what we can do is we can right-click on the rectangle, we can go to settings, and then save default. And then if we re-add a rectangle later, it's already going to have these parameters in place. And everything will already be created and it's all good to go. If you don't want to save that as default, but you want it to be able to be saved as a node in some other instance, you can right click settings and then save as. And then if we go up to the Fusion tab, we can go to macros. And then we can just do rectangle edges. I'll just call it that. Hit save. And then I can go ahead and reset this. And if I press shift space, I can type in rectangle edges. You'll see it here. And then we have our separate rectangle here, but we can also keep our normal rectangle intact as well. So that's how you create it. So this is just a fun little tutorial I wanted to create because I often see people saying, I wish I could just adjust each edge individually. Well, now you can. Of course, the only limitation is you can't use the Fusion overlay to adjust them. There is a slight workaround in the edit controls. If we go to edit controls and go to our, let's just say right, for example, and then you have your view control parameter, you can set that to rectangle. And let's just say we set it to center. We hit OK. Now we do have a way to move it from the Fusion overlay, although it is a little clunky. And if you go into like the negative values, then it kind of blurs out of control. But it is an option there if you want it. But I hope this tutorial is useful and gave you a little bit better of an idea of expressions and just gave you a useful tool in general. And then what would be useful for me is if you did the YouTube thing and then put words in the boxes below and then there's like a thumb. Just never mind, don't even worry about it. Look at that. You forgot to come up in the beginning, didn't you? All right, get out. Now if you want to see more Fusion tutorials, I have a playlist for Fusion stuff that I've done, as well as there's this video over here that is something recommended on my channel, I think. I'm not sure. I just made a dehancer video a little bit ago. You should probably check that out if you're interested in learning how that plugin works, and maybe you want to get it. Who knows? This is Camera Tim signing out. One could say this tool is an edge use case.